And I'm not quite sure what is meant by this, but it costs more to mine it than to actually buy it and own it. Is that what's
going on? Exactly right. And you nailed it on the head, essentially. That's exactly the crux of the argument. And that's not sustainable. There is a self-correcting mechanism in the algorithm whereby if the price goes down and miners exit, the cost of mining decreases, so the miners can continue to make profit. But it's not instantaneous, and there is a lag. And the rate at which the miners exit could be higher than the rate at which there is a decline in the price of a Bitcoin.
But your forecast is Bitcoin is worthless in the fairly near future. Is that it?
The idea really is, I mean, I guess mining is not like in traditional gold mining or anything of that sort. The miners are the ones which effectively provide the computational power to keep a record of who owns what. Okay. So if the cost of mining exceeds the price at which they can buy, they will stop mining. And if they stop mining, consequently, there will be no computing power provided to effectively maintain a ledger of who owns Bitcoin, and no transaction would be possible. And if there is no transaction happening and there is no record of who owns what, then all you have is a set of numbers. And then those numbers are worthless.
Atulia, you make a very good case, and I think I understand it, despite the technicalities of it. But I understand where you're coming from, and we'll be checking that price. Thank you very much, sir.
And so, once again, this interview for Fox News doesn't really go into depth because, yes, it's true that mining costs are going to drop, and there is an algorithm for cryptocurrencies, but what they're predicting, if Bitcoin is going to become worthless or is going to be worth zero, is that all mining activity stops. And I don't know if you guys have watched videos, but when Bitcoin started in 2009, 2010, you didn't have to have all this expensive equipment. You could just do it on your laptop to keep the system going, and it was actually profitable enough where people will do that. So if the infrastructure of Bitcoin starts to take a massive hit, eventually there'll just be people like ourselves that can just go and use your own laptop or your own CPU to do the mining. So obviously what's happened is when Bitcoin prices are very high, that basically eliminates the miners who are casual like you and I who want to just use normal computers. When the price is high, yes, then it does require heavy investment into infrastructure. And guess what? Those people are not going to just close shop. What they will do is they will adjust. They might have to reduce their electricity costs. They may not spend as much money upgrading their systems, and they may not have to because the algorithm will get easier and easier. So to say that completely all mining will stop and Bitcoin will go to zero doesn't make sense. And it's unfortunate. Like I said, I would basically, if I was on this interview or talking to him, and ask him that. I mean, if he's predicting that all mining activity will stop, there's been plenty of opportunities for this to happen. Bitcoin has corrected over 80% numerous times. And in fact, I believe the largest correction was almost 95 or 94%. So why didn't the mining activity stop back then? Why would it stop now? Now that it's even better known and has way more hype, that's going to allow more and more people to go in eventually once the price gets low enough. There's a lot more attention in Bitcoin now than it was 5 or 10 years ago when it could have easily died back then. So to think that it's going to die this time, I think it's just all hype. But let me know what you guys think about this article. You can check it out on MarketWatch or watch the entire interview on Fox News Business. And let me know what you think, and I will talk to you guys soon.